You wanted it. Here it is. Cambridge, Massachusetts, June 21st, Netrunner Regional Tournament at Pandemonium Books and Games. Elimination round. Now, I'm going to need all of you to go to the FFG website and get the Cut to 16 Netrunner Tournament Elimination Bracket. And look at that bracket. This is game number 6 on that bracket. I didn't record all first top table games, so look for game number 6 on your handy-dandy chart. On the left, we have Thomas. On the right, a familiar, amazing playmat, Chris M. You're wondering? I, sadly, did not make the cut. I had 14 prestige points at the end of 6 rounds of Swiss. We had a clean cut. Anyone with 15 or more prestige points made the cut. Anyone with 14 or fewer did not make the cut. Any one of those games you saw me lose could have turned it over. But it wasn't meant to be. But that's okay, because I was able to video these games more better. Because more better is great English. And I'm also not upset, because even though I didn't make it, that was a little bit of a dead weight. Of all the people from New York City, Team NYC Netrunner, that we brought with us to Cambridge, 4 of them, 4 of our people, made the top 16. 25% of the people who made the cut were my people, including Thomas on the left, playing MBN The Win Is Yours, full Astrobiotic Cheese. Chris M, the Andromeda deck, which you've already seen. Me lose to. Because my MBN had a bad draw. He's looking like he's having a great start, though. Great starts on both sides. You got wraparounds, quandaries, protecting all full 3 servers to block that data sucker, and to block the security testing right away. He's not even going to make a remote to let him security test. Boom. Is this a biotic? No, he's actually making a remote. That's very interesting for this deck. He's going to let him security test off that? It must be a Jackson Howard. That's the only explanation, is that that's a Jackson Howard. Well, the Yogg is letting him get into R&D. Oh, it's a Sansan. Okay. Well, he can security test off that Sansan, so I don't know if I'd leave it there without an ice on it. Hedge fund. I guess he spent all his money rezzing those ice. So he dirty laundry security tested somewhere to get a pile of money. Running R&D, seeing the one card his Yogg allows him to see. It's Astroscript. Oof. This might end quickly. Thomas really needs to draw an agenda here. I see he has a breaking news. He just scores it. Okay. He could fast track one. That's what this deck does. Force him to get the barrier breaker. Force him to try to grab one card in 6. Uh-oh, another breaking news. Uh-oh, another... This is going downhill really quickly. Pop-up window. Okay. Mandatory draw that pop-up window. 5-1. Wow. Okay, that must be the pop-up window. Yogg will still cut right through it, but at least he can get some money. But it's game point right now. And there's only one Astro in the deck. He absolutely must get it. Yep, he's using a fast track to go get it. He has no choice. I guess that also decreases the density in R&D. If he's going to run it and see another card, it's unlikely. Oh, here's the Corroder. Full rig, plus data sucker, plus pile of money from security testing, and it's game point. Corp is way behind. Sees the Biotic Laver. Yeah, he's going to score an Astro next turn if you don't stop him. Sees Biotic Laver again. Using the die to randomize this access. That's it. Whoa, he found it. 1 in 6. Well, 3 chances at 1 in 6. The fastest elimination game ever. Thomas goes down and goes down quick. Wow, when, you know, a criminal brings out the rig like that. Oof. Oof.